Welcome to the Glaze Studio. This is Momati Devasangaran, Founder CEO, the Guiding Light Art Company, building bright futures through art. Today, I am going to share with you the journey of the Glaze Studio to its virtual shop that has been built by Priyanka Asava. So here with me is Priyanka Asava. I would like to introduce her first to you, and then we will get on to show you what we have done. Thank you so much for joining in, Priyanka. If you could just give an overview about yourself to our audience.
So I have worked before in Accenture and then afterwards in ICT, a company in Delhi. And I worked on software. So I'm an MCA graduate. So I've done both back-end and front-end. So in Accenture, I was working on telecom billing. And in ICT, I was working on various things. I mean, I had different projects every 2-3 months. So that was very interesting for me. So yeah, there I had got chance to develop websites, both on .NET as well as on WordPress. So it was a very nice experience, and that has really helped me to work on your website better. Yeah.
Yes. I think it's been a wonderful experience. We will talk more about the experience also.
This is our website. And here are the sliders. So this will give you an idea of what are the things Gomti is working on, both paintings and art classes. And this is how it will look in your house. This was the basic idea that give the user how it will look in their house. That was totally Gomti's idea. So yes, I think we have achieved it.
Yes. Yeah.
And this is, I think, Gomti's favorite section, students.
Yes.
She's very passionate about it. And yes. She has very, really nice students, I can see by the paintings.
Yes. Little ones do take over, yes.
So here are the two online courses which you're planning. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Pencil sketch and oil painting.
Yes.
So here are the categories. Yeah. We have students art, oil painting, and we have pencil sketching, we have private art commissions. So it actually gives the user full platter or full color palette of this website. So what are the different colors on this? You can see in first page itself, and you can decide where you want to go.
Yeah.
Yeah, beautiful paintings which makes the website more beautiful.
Yes, thank you.
Yeah. So here you have information about whom you can contact, how you can contact, and all the social media links.
Yes.
And we have this website both in Danish and English. So that everyone can view this. So yeah, this we have in English.
And we can also, yeah, switch over to Danish language.
Yeah, whatever you're comfortable with.
Awesome. And just to add, the student section is building up. We are trying to provide more and more space for the students. We have around 8 students here, and we want to add more. Due to the corona, we can also see that the possibility is less practically. So we have also introduced online classes, which you can see. And so that is about the website. Maybe you can just go through any of the links.
I think I'll show the classes which you
have.
As
an example, yeah.
So here are the two classes, and you know how many classes would be there, how long it would be there, which day it would be there, and all the materials required for that. So if someone wants to register, they have to just click on this button and they'll be moved to a registration form. I think in Corona times, this is the best you can do.
Yeah.
So charcoal graphite art. And you have the categories listed over here. So also we have listed all the categories on this side. So you can move between categories just in one click. You don't have to search anywhere. So maybe if you want to see something related to oil on canvas, you can just click. And you can see.
That is awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you very much for this short intro. I think it's easy for people to now go over and see what they can get out of this website. I am so happy to have worked on this experience, and I want to touch base on our experiences. Usually we share in the channel what we are doing together, whether it is with children or, you know, on other topics as well. So this is our moment, and I want to share some experiences that I felt working with you. First thing was definitely it was very transparent, and you were, the work ethic that you have was very good. That made me also get better at what I should do as a person that is wanting a website. As an artist, of course, we imagine a lot of things. Like you also said, you know, there are great ideas, you know, but how to put it in a website format, and that's something that you helped very well with, I think. So thank you so much for that. Did feel very comfortable working with you on that, and we started, just to give you an overview on how did we get started with this and how much time we took. I think we met only in February to just get to know that, okay, there's someone that could help me out with this. And then we started our first discussion in the first week of March, that is just 1 month backwards. And 9th yeah. of March, officially, we tap into this domain, the Glaze Studio, and then we start the work officially. And then here we are, finishing it up. It's such a beauty. And this has been also a very pleasant journey for me, because this is not my domain. And I learned a lot through this process, how to maintain a website, what is more important, what is not, and how to present also in a website format. So I'm so thankful that we did this together.
It was also smooth and quick, because you were clear what you want to put on the website. You were able to answer my queries straightforward in yes or no. Mm-hmm. So that, that made the process quicker and smoother for both of us. We did not lose any time in rework. We were clear. Before doing, we were clear what we want and where we want. So that made all the difference.
Yeah. I want to ask certain things. You know, there's always a positive point that we always highlight on many aspects, but then there were challenges also. First thing, when I walked up to you, I said, okay, the website has to be by default Danish language. English has to be the, you know, optional language, or the one that could be selected by the customer. How was it for you?
It was a little difficult for me, because I'm just learning Danish for sure, but I am not to that level that I can do everything in Danish. Mm-hmm. So it was a little bit difficult for me, but with your help, I had the content in Danish. So I did not have to worry about proofreading it or anything. And since the data was clear and place where the data has to be placed was clear, so it was easier for me. And it also helped me improve my Danish. Because when you change the language in WordPress to Danish, then the whole, you know, setup comes in Danish.
Yeah.
So yeah, I did learn few more words in Dinesh, so that really helped me. It was a challenge, but yeah, I did.
I agree.
Get to know many new things.
One thing I would highlight here is that when I said, of course, the whole language has to be Danish, I think it's pretty much the structure that people work in English language in WordPress, because that's the work environment, and you were in the English language trying to set things up for me and then getting the input in Danish language. But at one point, you switched gears. You turned the whole website into Danish as the default language, and you were actually working on everything that was written in Danish. And I saw that as, you know, someone that's going beyond the comfort zone and trying to make it perfect. I think that's where the strategy is, because when we want to make a dual language website, I'm not an expert at this, but when you want to make a dual language website, if we again go back to the source language, as let's say, for example, English language, and we make it, and then we say that we will switch in the last minute, there is a lot of disappointment. But when we do it vice versa, also given that Danish is one of the top 10 world's most difficult languages, so it's not so easy to convert it from English to Danish. It doesn't happen in a day. And the strategy was good that we used Danish as the language of working, and then we shifted it
to English. Yeah.
Yes.
And it was easier to check the translation in English, because yeah, I knew what is going to be translated, and if it is something wrong, we can just edit it. So yeah, that was much easier, in fact.
Yeah. And one thing I learned aside from this was the look and feel of it in a desktop versus mobile phone, which I was definitely not prepared for. The moment you asked me to prepare some slides or, you know, pictures, I did something that was definitely not good for
See,
mobile.
You are an artist, so I cannot, you know, lose the chance of getting best from you, because you are an artist. An artist, I is very different. So yeah, I fully dependent on you for graphics, because I knew you will put your paintings in a better way, because you know how you want to present it. So that's what I was keen that you did the graphics work as per your, you know, understanding and like, because you should also like the website, and you should be showing what you want to show to the people who are visiting your website. So yeah. But I did give a lot of suggestions, and I made you do a lot of changes as per the requirements of the website. But you were, you know, calm, and you did the changes which I wanted. So, yeah.
I could see that pushing me towards getting the best out of it. So I also needed to step up, because, you know, as owner of the website, we need to own up to that responsibility also. It's not just, you know, putting the name that we are owning a website. It's a huge responsibility. So ultimately, we are responsible for any content that we are putting out there in on the net.
True.
And I think we did show that responsibility towards each other. And I really appreciate the time and effort that you had put in on this. Is there anything else that you would like to share with the audience, Priyanka?
It was actually, this project for me was not as a work. I felt like I am back to my college days doing some group project, you know. At one point, it was difficult to say you're working for my website or I'm working for your website. Because... So that was the level of involvement from both of the people. Because if people say, okay, I have a website for my shop or any XYZ, and if they are not involved in the process, that, you know, reduces even my amount of interest, because if I don't get immediate responses on or the feedback from the client, then the first thing is process is delayed, and then the work is not up to the mark.
No.
Both the people have to be equally involved and equally passionate about that work, and it should not feel like work.
Yeah.
Then it would come out better.
Yeah.
So, like, for 2 days, the server was down. And we had to, you know, somehow work in that just 1 or 2 minute gap. Whatever we get on the server, we were doing some changes. And after that, the next day, we sat for so long. But it was not stressful or hectic. We were enjoying that part also.
Yeah.
If we are working in that way, in that environment, plus you were very accommodative, you were ready to come to my place. My daughter was there. She was continuously interacting with you. You were very calmly, patiently handling her. And that also made a lot of difference. It gave a level of comfort between you and me working at my place, with everything going on around us. So it did not felt like work. It felt like a group project in college, in for which we are all involved, passionate, and we wanted the best to be presented.
Yeah. That's nice. I have one thing to ask you. I'm sure, you know, you've been 1 year plus in Denmark, and you are also building up on your language base. I can see you know more words now in the
English. Yes.
And maybe you will be getting more and more of such projects where dual language is involved, or, you know, more complexities. What are your expectations from people who want to approach you?
First of all, involvement. Because if we go to or move to a bigger organization, then if I am able to interact with the person who will have a final say in what has to be put on the website, then it will be a quicker and smoother process. And I have to understand, see, every business is there on net now.
Yeah.
But what is unique in your business? It is only you, the owner, or the person responsible about it should interact with me and share that with me, so that that uniqueness of your business is properly put on the website. We should be able to make the people visiting the website know what is unique about you. So it is not like they give some content, I give some design, they like it, don't like it. Then they say we have to get approval or something. Then it delays down the process, and it is not it is not natural. No, it should be natural in the sense that it should come from your passion. It should be your passion. Then you can give me better information about your business, and I can build a better website for you.
Yeah.
So that is very important. Involvement and proper information, data, like you had all the contents for every page ready. That reduced so much time for me. And you were clear what are the pages which are going to... If we see, we were just working on the design and content for initial 13 days, I guess. 13 hours, I guess.
Hours,
13
yeah.
hours we were working
hours.
Only on that. What kind of design will be there? We tried many different things. We tried different templates. Then we thought, okay, this template is good. What are the things we are going to change? And when we were clear, the design part was clear and all the prototyping was clear, then I really started working on the website.
Yeah.
So that made all the difference. So we have to invest that time. And at that time, I need everyone's proper involvement, because both parties have to be properly involved at that time to speed up the process. Involvement and proper information and correct information. Because if they say one day this and the next day they want to change the whole thing, it is not easy to do on web, because you have made few changes according to that according to the discussion which we had previously, and then when you want to change it, then again it is a double work. So it will only delay your work.
Clarity.
Yeah.
I did notice that from your end, you were also making an effort to go through the content that I already have on the net to understand what all I could bring out. It was a huge help. From a end user point of view who just wants a website, I can imagine why people also are finding it difficult, because I thought when I started out, I thought, okay, I have been making content almost every day for the past 1 year. So I have enough data to put through. But then when it comes to presenting it, there are certain aspects that won't work. So you need to really go through the humongous content which you already think you have and pick up the right ones to show and present. And that was a learning experience. Okay, you cannot just use anything and everything. So maybe people are feeling a little intimidated about that. Any words of suggestions for those who are, okay, there's a lot, but I don't know how to put it.
No, I will just put it simply. Don't think about web page. Think about if you want to open a shop, okay? Mm-hmm. And you have just a land. You have nothing, okay? Mm-hmm. So you will call a builder who will build it. You will call an architect who will design it.
Yeah.
But will you stop going into the shop, or every time the architect will open the shop? No. And you have to give proper information to the builder. You have to give proper information to the designer. Mm-hmm. Then you will get what you want.
Yeah.
So website is just as good as that. So we had went through different platforms which we can use for website designing. And then we chose what is relevant for us, what is more important. See, the priority differs from person to person. Your priorities were different, so we opted for a particular platform.
Yeah.
If someone else's priorities are different, we'll choose another platform. Agreed. That's why I made sure that you go through all the platforms and see positive and negative of everything and decide for yourself what you want for your company.
Mm.
See, I cannot decide for you. So if you want to open a shop, I can decide for you what kind of shop you should have, what should be the size of the shop, how it should be built. You have to give that information to me. You will not do it on your own, but you have to give your ideas. Mm. Then it would be built in the way you want.
Yeah.
So you have to just take it in that sense and work. Technology is not so complicated at this point of time, I would say, because everyone has a Facebook page, everyone has a Twitter handle. So everyone to an extent knows technology, and they are technology literate, I can say that.
Yeah.
So, and Corona has made it even more, you know, evident that everyone has to be online and work online. So I think when you have so much of exposure to online things, then making a website should not be intimidating. It's as good as, you know, maintaining your Facebook page.
Yep.
But you are having your own place, and you will display the data or whatever you want to display the way you want.
Mm.
It's just that.
Anything else that you wanted to say if we have missed?
Yeah, I would like to say Happy Easter.
Happy Easter, everyone. Yes. And if somebody wants to reach out to a consultant that can help in this process of building a website, how do they reach Priyanka Asawa?
Yeah, so I have my LinkedIn page. I opened a company. Its name is Sanvi Tech Solutions. So you can get in touch with me by mobile or by email.
Yeah.
And I'll answer your queries for sure.
We will flash that on the tab.
Sure.
Yes. Thank you very much, Priyanka. It has been a pleasure. And for people who are wondering, okay, where is the change management thing? It is all gone. Priyanka is still with me. We are again getting started next week. building on another website, and we will come back soon with what we have got for the people who are enjoying watching Change Management series. So thank you very much, Priyanka.
Thank you. Thank you.
Happy Easter again.
Happy Easter.